Hi, and welcome back to our Q&A series. Today we've got Anna Kwan from Beloved Bumps, and she is our pre and postnatal exercise specialist, and she's going to be answering all your questions to do with exercise, when you can get back into exercise, what is diastasis recti, and lots of other questions. Again, if you have anyone that you want us to ask questions of, or you have any specific questions for anyone, please feel free to send them in either to belovedbumps@gmail.com or via our website. So today we have Anna, who is actually from Beloved Bumps, and she is our prenatal and postnatal exercise specialist, and she's going to be answering our questions, everything to do with diastasis and returning back to exercise for those who are at that point. So over to you, Anna, if you could just tell us who you are and what you do.
Hi ladies, I'm the pre and postnatal exercise specialist with Beloved Bumps. So I see a lot of new mums, both on a one-on-one basis, and also we run classes with Beloved Bumps for core strengthening, core rehab. So a lot of the work I do is in core rehab to manage diastasis and the other problems that exist with diastasis. So a lot of the time people will come to me with sore backs or hips, weak glutes, and diastasis is a similar consequence of that.
Perfect. So speaking of diastasis, what the hell is it?
Okay, so diastasis is it's separation of your superficial abdominal muscles. So it happens quite a lot in pregnancy, kind of 70% of cases usually. As your baby grows, your uterus expands and kind of puts a lot of pressure on your deep core muscles. These muscles get really weak. They stretch. The connective tissue that surrounds them gets weaker, stretches. And then the superficial muscles, which are kind of lying like this, they don't actually join up. They're lying like this on top of the connective tissue and they just get pulled apart. Okay, so that's basically what a diastasis recti is. It's a separation of about 2 to 5, say, centimeters of fingers. We measure with fingers. So, I mean, it can get quite wide, like the size of your hand, in quite severe cases.
How would someone know that they've got it? And can you test for it yourself, or does someone need to do that for you?
Yeah, it's the problem with diastasis is in quite a lot of cases, people are unaware they actually have it to start with. As I was saying before, diastasis is a consequence of a dormant core, and there are lots of other factors that exist with a diastasis. So quite a lot of the time you'll have kind of chronic low back pain or hip pain or like really weak glutes, pelvic floor dysfunction is a big one. And you'll notice these problems first, and then your diastasis, this is the issue, will in time get a little bit worse. So you can, I mean, saying that, some women have noticeable, you can get a noticeable bulging along the midline of your body. Sometimes this is quite apparent, as I say, other times it's not. It's always best to go to either women's health physio or somebody like myself to get yourself checked out. So always try and do that. Obviously at the moment it's quite difficult, but try and do that as soon as you can. You can check yourself if you were to lie on your back and bend your knees up and then just place your, so you're trying to palpate just above and just below the belly button. As I say, it's a gap you're looking for, but you'd be looking for the tension. So if you can feel kind of squidginess, I guess, like just above and below the belly button, then that's a really good sign that you have got a diastasis. But I always say to people as well that if you're less than 6 weeks postpartum, just assume you have one. Most people do to some degree, even if it's like one finger. Yeah. And it can get worse. This is the problem. So yeah, always assume you do.
Okay, so how long after having a baby can you go back into exercise?
Again, that's one of those questions. It very much depends on your core strength. So diastasis happens because your core muscles stop functioning properly. So you need your core muscles to function to get the stability back in your spine and pelvis. Now, you can return to exercise once you have that stability back. So, I mean, you get the green card from the gynaecs at about 6 weeks, but it's way too soon. And most of the time at six weeks, myself included, you're not ready and you don't have that stability in your midsection. So if you're then trying to exercise with kind of an injured core, you're just going to cause yourself a lot of problems in the future. When's a good time is when your core is strong enough to kind of sustain whatever you want to be doing.
And what happens if someone returns to things like running or like weight training at that 6 week mark and goes straight into it?
Yeah, it's very soon, 6 weeks. So even if you feel kind of really strong, really fit, and we get this quite a lot, I get quite a lot of clients who kind of work out throughout the pregnancy and they feel like they're really strong, and you might be, but your insides probably aren't. Okay. So if you're trying to run or lift heavy weights or anything like that at the 6 point mark, then there's far too much pressure on your deep core muscles, particularly your pelvic floor. You're more likely to prolapse further down the line or cause yourself other issues, chronic lower back pain, as say problems like hips, glutes, all of these issues kind of don't go away. So 6 weeks is far too soon.
And you mentioned it can get worse over time. So what do you mean by that? Is that if you kind of do anything, or how does it get worse?
So at the six week mark, once you've got the strength and stability in your core, so core rehab, you can literally do from 2 weeks inwards. Okay. Once you get to the 6 week mark, you can move gently, like gentle exercise. So you're talking about walking, cycling, not spinning, like cycling slowly, anything that involves very low impact. You don't want to be doing any kind of exercise that requires you to hold your breath or that creates lactic acid, that you get tired. So, I mean, we're talking very, very gentle exercise. You can start to introduce body weight movements and very, very light resistance. If your spine or your pelvis can remain stable when you're doing that, then you're okay to introduce it slowly at 6 weeks. But just be really kind of wary about it all. It takes time. And if you rush it, then that's when the problems exist.
Yeah, definitely. Okay. And is there a difference if you have a vaginal birth or a cesarean birth in terms of returning to exercise?
So with a C-section, it's abdominal major abdominal surgery. So it does take a bit longer, at least 2 or 3 weeks, add on to your timeline and just go really, really gentle. Just be wary that you've injured your core from your pregnancy and from your C-section. So it's kind of a double hit and you've just got to take a little bit more time with the recovery. Mm-hmm.
Okay, so for anyone who is coming up to that 6 week mark and wants to get back into exercise, kind of things should they be looking for? Postnatal specific exercise classes, or how should they go about getting back into that?
Okay, so at the 6 week mark, I would always suggest going to see a women's health physio or someone to check out your diastasis, check out how your pelvic floor is, work on your core rehab, so anything that involves core strengthening, to really isolate those deep core muscles. In terms of classes, like Pilates is good, anything that's low impact, the bar classes are good. Very basic yoga, but you've got to be kind of very careful with yoga, with the flows, the dynamic work. Just avoid anything that's impact. So avoid any kind of impact classes, especially in a group scenario, because you obviously don't get as much attention from the instructor, so it's a bit more difficult in that sense.
So you run your postnatal exercise classes, and this is obviously something that you work on in those, and currently we are doing them virtually, so technically anyone from over the world can join in with you. And is this work that you do in your classes just to help with that diastasis?
Yeah, so all the exercises we do in the classes are based on core rehab. So it's kind of isolating and strengthening your deep core muscles, your pelvic floor. So it's like your base level that everybody needs to work on first before they go back to exercise. So we get a lot of new mums who haven't done anything else before they come to class, which is exactly the way we want it. You should be doing this first. We've got a level two class, which obviously progresses up, and it's a lot more difficult. But yeah, level one core is where you need to start with, basically.
Awesome. Thanks so much for answering all of our questions today. I think that's all of the questions that we had. And then if anyone wants to get in contact with Anna, you can find her via our website, belovedbumps.sg. And also they can get in contact with you via WhatsApp, I think, as well.
Yes, by WhatsApp or email, anna@belovedbumps.sg. We just said that, haven't we? Or WhatsApp.
Perfect. Thank you.
Thanks, Tash. Bye-bye.